And if you're not in shape, the walk from Raven Hill to main campus will get you in shape. I definitely think the no air conditioning thing was a pitfall for me, and it'll help you grow up a little bit and learn how to pop a Kraft mac and cheese in the microwave, you know what I'm saying?
I'm in the shot, y'all. How you doing?
So hopefully that is just angled and I'm not. I just want to show you guys that I'm wearing really cute mom jeans. But you can't see them. Now you can see them. And now you can't. It is what it is. I was wearing this exact outfit in my first Jefferson University video, which I think is funny. What's up, guys? Welcome back to another video. It's me, Emily, and today I am giving all you Jefferson freshmen my best tips and advice for your first year. Specifically at Jefferson, I made a video in the past that was just freshman advice, but this is specifically for a lot of my subscribers that came because you have questions about Jefferson, you have questions about a bunch of different things. So I did my best to be super specific in this list. I'm gonna be looking over here at my laptop. Oh, so that light kind of made it better. We'll keep that on. These tips are in literally no order. I'm just giving you tips like I am your tour guide and I have 40 minutes to tell you guys everything that I think that you need to know that's important. It's gonna be a little bit crazy. Some things may not make sense until you actually start going. And I apologize in advance in case anything I say is like outdated because I was a freshman 2 years ago. I'm about to be a rising junior. So things may be a little bit different. Things may change. I've already heard that some things have changed when it comes to like Fortes and housing and stuff. And then there's COVID. So forgive me if some things are not applicable, but most of them I think are. So if you got a pen and a paper, just start writing, or at least keep them up here because you'll need these. Tip number one is more friends equals better housing. And this may sound like the shallowest thing you've ever heard, but it's the truth. When you are a freshman, that is the easiest time for you to make friends. And the more friends you have, the better your housing will be. Let me explain. Your first year, you might get thrown into a double, triple, or quad in whatever housing you get placed in randomly, and then you have an entire semester slash year to make friends and figure out who your group of people is going to be. Then it will come to sophomore year, and you're going to want to live in IP, but what do you need to live in IP? Which is Independence Plaza, which are the apartments on campus. In order to live in the apartments, you will need either two or three other people to live with. So I've experienced this firsthand. It is so difficult and not worth living with people you don't know who could potentially make your semester a tragedy or a terror. You don't want to live with people you don't know. So freshman year, jump in, make friends the best that you can, and get those forever roommates, those forever friends, because you'll be so grateful in your junior, senior year when you can live in a townhouse with your besties and not have to find random people to live with just to make it five people so you can live in a townhouse. Does that make sense? I hope so. The next tip on here is leave for class 15 minutes early because the sweat stains are not worth it. So if you know, then you know, Raven Hill is a good walk from main campus. It is a long periodically walk. And if you're not in shape, the walk from Raven Hill to main campus will get you in shape. So always give yourself about 15 minutes to do that walk. Don't leave 7 minutes, don't leave 10 minutes. Just do it 15 minutes early. So even if you have extra time, you'll be early for class, or you can just hang out. Because literally rushing when you're late for class and you're doing that walk, it feels like a race, like sweating. You also have to wait for traffic. So you have to wait for like the walk sign to be up in order to cross over to main campus. So I would definitely say leave 15 minutes early is a really good gauge. Speaking of leaving 15 minutes early, my next tip is do not ever trust the ram van to get you anywhere on time. So the ram van can be very, very helpful in like cold weather or when you're late for class, but I definitely would not trust it. That's why I say leave 15 minutes early in case you need to walk, because sometimes the ram van is supposed to be there every 15 minutes. I think the schedule actually did change now for COVID, so it's like less frequent, but my advice is to not really trust it to begin with because it could really take like 30 minutes that you'll be waiting for it. Sometimes it's just better to walk, or if you're not running late for class, then just take the bus. But and it gets so full. It gets like unimaginably full which I think is also different now because of COVID, which is sad. You don't get the full college experience. Gosh, I feel so bad for you guys. Okay, next. My next tip slash piece of advice is that Ravenhill dining is really good, but it's also very heavy. It's very, very heavy food. It's fries, it's grilled cheese, it's like Wing Wednesday, it's breakfast sandwiches. Like, the food is good, and you're gonna be like, oh my gosh, like, my high school could never. But just be careful, because like, those are the foods that are not exactly going to be fueling your brain to feel great. So now that I'm an upperclassman, which I think is funny because in my other video I said I feel like upperclassmen, only more upperclassmen eat at Common Thread than anywhere else, which is true. And now that I'm an upperclassman, I eat at Common Thread more than anywhere else, because they just have more healthy food options. Like, one day maybe I want a wrap, one day maybe I want pierogi. So definitely diversify your options there, and don't just eat at Ravenhill, because you will get fat. You will gain weight, or at least you're just gonna feel really gross a lot of the time, or really sleepy a lot of the time. Also, it's so much easier now because you can just order things on your phone. You have to get like this Transact app, and you can literally just go through and order whatever you want from like any of the places. So it's a lot easier now than it used to be, let's be honest. My next piece of advice, listen for all of you who are going to be living on campus slash have questions about where's the best place to dorm. And this is 100% my personal opinion. I have not lived in any of the other dorms, but all I have to say is, if I were you, I would live in Fortez. You heard it here first. Girls, if I were you, I would live in Fortez. It's an all-girls building. It's such a great place for you to get comfortable your first year. You have like a group of girls that you can room with. I don't know, I think the numbers change now, but you can make friends. And I don't know, to me it was just like comfortable. And the rooms are bigger. I definitely think the no air conditioning thing was a pitfall for me, but it wasn't to the point that I was like, oh my gosh, never. Like, if I could choose to live somewhere else again, I would still live in Fortez. It's like right in the middle of the parking lot. So like, it's easy when you want to get picked up or when you're moving out. Oh my gosh, like, just live in Fortez, just do it. I only ever lived with one other roommate, so I can't speak for triples or quads, but usually they're set up as bunk beds. But I'm so thankful I did not get a bunk bed, because I'm not built for that. Absolutely not. My next piece of advice is that your major is not set in stone. So I kind of had this fear after my first semester that I was not going to be able to switch out of pre-med, that like, it was going to ruin everything and I was going to graduate 2 years late. But I'm okay. I'm a little bit behind, but I'm okay. So your major, when you go in as a certain major, it's not the major that you have to stay with. I will say that if you're switching from something that's like fashion to like medicine, or medicine to fashion, like, some of those credits won't transfer, but a lot of times they'll fill in the slots for free electives. So that's a plus for you, but never feel like you're stuck if you really don't want to be somewhere, because not that your major decides your whole life, but your major is eventually going to be your career, most likely. So just make sure that you're on the right path, and a path that feels good for you. But my next tip is to please, please, please leave your room for your own sanity. And I said this in one of my like roommate tip videos, I think, which is super old and I honestly hate it, but leave your room. Give your roommates peace of mind and give yourself peace of mind. If you are holed up in a dorm room that has one window, barely any air circulation, and you're like cut off from society, you're gonna go nuts, and you're not even gonna realize why you're going nuts, and it's because you haven't gotten out. Get out, go to Canbar. You may have to wear a mask, but at least you have a change of scenery. I'm just telling you, it'll help you so much. And another good tip, bonus tip, is to do your homework in different places. Like, don't just do it in the library, don't just do it in your room, go to different places, because it'll spark some like creativity and productivity in you. Definitely, I've seen that in myself. Another short tip is to take advantage of first year experience. They have a bunch of different activities planned for freshmen, like Eastern State Penitentiary, College Fest. I did a couple of those things my freshman year, but I definitely wish I would have taken more advantage of doing things, because they're usually discounted and transportation is usually provided and people usually travel in bulk. So it's just really fun, safe, and it's a good way to make friends. And I had on here where you can walk for fun. I walked to Rite Aid to get my groceries, which was like a 5-10 minute walk, if that, from Ravenhill, depending on how fast you're walking. It's like right behind Ravenhill, it's super close. But that's where I got my groceries or essentials if I ever needed any. And Rite Aid, because it's like a pharmacy. It's not like Walmart. It's like kind of expensive, but it's still affordable. There's still some things that are affordable. Just a little ways down past Rite Aid, there's like this little main street type of area. There's a park, and there are some other things. But I would just say for my girls that are freshmen, don't walk down there alone, because it's, the crowd down there is definitely a little bit more mixed, if you understand what I'm saying. So I definitely would not walk alone, even though I did it multiple times. That's just because I have no friends. I'm sorry, I'm so stuffy. I think I have allergies. Another tip for grocery shopping is to get those reusable, like, plastic bags. Go to the store with them, shop, put everything in your basket, and then carry them back. If you have to walk, carry them back to Raven Hill with, those plastic bags. I used to just get like the Rite Aid bags, and I would be carrying like 6 bags, and I'd be like, oh my gosh, I don't know what to do with myself, you're so heavy. But I got like 2 of the reusable bags, and it changed my life. So that's a really good tip. My next tip of advice is to go to the gym. Just go to the gym, work out, feel good, take a load off. It's a really good way to expend energy and blow off steam. So definitely use the money that you're already paying for your gym membership at the school and just go to the gym. Just do it. And my final tip to you Jefferson freshmen and some of you upperclassmen, if you happen to be watching this video, is to not DoorDash ever. Just don't do it. This might just be from my own personal experience, and I know that like sometimes you're like, oh my gosh, it's late, the dining hall's closed, I'm starving, and I understand there are some circumstances where you might want to, but DoorDash has robbed me of so much money while I'm on campus that it's insane. Like, just go to the store, plan it out, and get your groceries, and don't waste your money on DoorDash. DoorDash is really expensive for no reason, and it's better for you to use your money on stuff that you can like make or warm up than using it on like one hot meal that is gonna cost you like $30 or $20 or something, and then you're gonna have to go out to meet them and they get confused coming onto campus. And I mean, it's fine, but I'm just saying don't DoorDash, because it will save you so much money and it'll help you grow up a little bit and learn how to pop a Kraft mac and cheese in the microwave. You know what I'm saying? I think it's a waste of money, and I just don't think it's worth it, even though it's really enticing to do when you're on campus and you don't have a car. All right, guys, that's it for today's video. I hope that this Jefferson freshman advice was helpful for you. I hope that you literally take these and apply them to your first year, because it will really, really help you. And if you have any questions, as always, direct message me on Instagram, comment down below. I usually respond to every single comment. Comment down below and let me know what your major is, because I'd be really interested to hear like what my viewers are majoring in at Jefferson. I think that's like the best question. It like says so much about a person. Also, give this video a thumbs up if it was helpful so more people can find the video. And I think that's all I want to say. I love you all so much, but God loves you more, and I will see you in the next video.